canvas and I'll dry. And I will start painting. First I will do a simple painting. I will use only a few colors in this one. And the colors I use are called Yavana, because they are different, very good silk paints out on the market, but I like this one the best, because I like the flow to this color. I have tried other ones, but I go back to this one. You have to shake the bottles before opening them, because the pigment has a tendency to fall to the bottom when standing right. I use yellow, two sorts of red, and a green one. The main thing is water. It's very, very important. A paper towel and, of course, brushes. I use different sizes. I like to use large brushes. I start with the yellow color. I want the center of the flower to have a yellow color. So, I first put the brush into the water and then into the color. And you can see, when I put the brush onto the silk, the color starts floating. And the more color you put into your brush, the more easy it is floating. In fact, I use a bit of water as I go on. If I don't, the color will stop and it dries very fast at the edges. So you will get hard lines between the different colors. But if you put a bit of water before you do the next color, the colors will float into each other like this. Now it seems as if they are all together, these colors, but when you wash the gutta away, you will see the white lines will stay. The silk will stay white where you put the gutta material. Use a bit of water, because when I use this is a pretty dark red, but when I use water it turns out almost pink. I draw the color out to the completely to the edge. Wash the brush and dry it on the paper. I did holes in my gutta lines just to show you how it will look if you don't fill the whole line. If you have holes in your gutta line. Here, you can see, it has been floating outside the line. But that we fix afterwards. That's no problem. Then we let these reds dry a little bit, because then I use an even darker red out. As an outline. And if I let it dry, not completely dry, because then the effect will not be there. To get this effect for the dark red to be drawn into the lighter one, it has to be a little bit damp. But if I did it now, when it is wet, I wouldn't get the effect. Then I do a bit green on the leaves. I first, like I did with the red one, put the brush into the water and then into the color. You don't need solid color. You use a lot of water when painting on silk. Here I use only one green color because I will show you how to create effects just by adding water to this green color. To get that water effect, the silk has to be damp only, just like I told you on the flower. Because when I put clean water in my brush up on top of this green, you will see that you get light lines following your brush. And then it looks as if you have used several colors and you have only, in fact, used one. I think I even use a bit of green in the center of this flower. I will now try to do the effect on the leaves just by using water. I fill my brush with water and it may be too early. I will show you close up. Simply have water in your brush and you can see it creates lines. Creating different shades in the green. Is to take the darkest red to sort of create an effect. It may be even not, it may be too early, but I take the bottom of each, the outer edge of each petal. To create the shadow effect. On the flower. And afterwards we use the water technique, thin brush, to do some more effect using water on the leaves. And I take some of the yellow to do some lines at the center of the petals. That too will create a nice effect. You know, silk paint, you can change your painting as you go on. But you can change from a dark color that is a giant dark color into a lighter one. That is impossible. From a lighter to a darker, that is okay.